Yes, I see.
Yeah, okay then.
I
They work tirelessly to deliver the medical curriculum here at the university and who play an important role in this class that we're celebrating today. I ask that you stand when your name is called and remain standing until I have called everyone. Dr. Jeremy Welsh, College of Medical Science Dean. Dr. Jenna Ross, College of Medical Science Associate Dean. Dr. David Truitt, Medical Director. Dr. Nicoletta Nellis, Director of Didactic Education. Dr. Megan Castro, Director of Clinical Education. Dr. Eric Schmidt, Principal Faculty. Dr. Joseph Bowman, Principal Faculty. Dr. Tessa Rolston, Principal Faculty. Dr. Amy Kopko, Clinical Assistant Professor. Dr. Jamie Schuler, DMSC Associate Program Director. And Dr. Joni Morcom, Adjunct Faculty. I'd also like to take an opportunity to introduce Mr. Tripp Jones, the College of Medical Science Admissions Coordinator. He is up in the back, already standing. And Mr. Virgil Oxendine, the College of Medical Science Administrative Assistant. Unable to be with us today are Dr. Marcy Koth, Clinical Assistant Professor, Dr. Elaine Nichols, Adjunct Faculty, Dr. Nathan Kennedy, Adjunct Faculty, Professor Andrew Masif, Adjunct Faculty, Dr. Greer Trainum, Adjunct Faculty, and Professor Mary Griffin, Adjunct Faculty. Please take a moment to recognize these individuals. Our program and our students are only successful because of their dedication and hard work.
Sacred One, source of purpose in life, we gather with hearts filled with gratitude and souls bursting with anticipation. We give thanks for the way life has opened the door for these students to begin this academic and professional journey. For this cohort, who will be a strong support and foundation for their future efforts, studies, and compassionate care, and for all that they will encounter in this journey, we give thanks. And when the days ahead become long and challenging, joyous and celebratory, coffee-filled and sleep-deprived, may they trust that goodness, that centeredness, that compassion will follow them all the days of their
demonstrate years of use in the lab, and I wouldn't want to wear them anywhere near the clinic. So you have chosen to study at the University of Lynchburg. What does that mean for you? Lynchburg's faculty and staff are dedicated to helping you succeed, and they can point you to many avenues of support that are available to help ensure your success. Your faculty will challenge you in the classroom and in the clinic, and we all expect you to seek new challenges wherever you may be and in whatever you do. Your patients will challenge you to learn more than you think you can. Accepting and meeting challenges will force you to stretch and to grow, and I think that's why you're here. Lynchburg faculty are here to help you add to your story. And this summer, you have experienced the great spirit of the University of Lynchburg community. You will learn that while on campus, our campus is one of the most beautiful campuses in the nation. This university truly is greater than its physical manifestations. Our hope for you is that your intellectual story will be marked by deep inquiry and an unceasing search for truth and learning. You will find that Lynchburg provides ample opportunities for intellectual, clinical, and cultural enrichment. But the depth and the breadth of your story depends on you and the choices that you make. In 2 short years, when we sit at commencement, the president will speak to you, reflecting on what these years have meant to you and outline all that your class has achieved. We will experience a lot together between now and then. You will be different people, and your stories will be different, and you will have been changed by what you learn, the patients you have met, and the relationships you have formed. I can't wait to hear your stories. And honestly, every year I hear about engagements, marriages, and children. So when I say your lives will be different, trust me on that. Please know that the entire university community is here to support and sustain and encourage you. We could not be more excited or privileged to welcome you into our vibrant learning community. It is you who make us who we are, and we look forward to the fresh ideas and the energy that you bring to campus. I speak for the entire faculty, staff, and student community in Lynchburg in saying that we are so happy you have made a new decision to join us, and it is a great day to be a Hornet. Thank you.
Most of your curiosity will be met I'm not asking you to be belligerent about it, but curious often leads to needing to be courageous around how we discuss and how we dialogue about what we want to do to either make our patients' life better, our practices better, the system or the region we work in better. So be courageous around what you do every single day. Be willing to stand up when many around you will probably opt to sit down. That is what will make the difference. Again, I share my story, and that there was really no reason that I would ever go to college. Most of my high school friends did not. There would really be no reason that I would be accepted into PA school. If you have not heard my story, I honestly did not know what a PA was when I got into PA school. So very difficult now. And the reason I was able to do those things and eventually is I feel truly that grit makes a difference. As life becomes challenging, many will eventually be able to become complacent with what they're doing. That's not always a bad thing. But I see all of you in the building, studying, enjoying what you're doing, hopefully enjoying your camaraderie as a team. 21 years ago I was in your seat, but 20 years ago I graduated, and I'm still very close friends with many of those classmates. So continue to grow together. Continue to build on that grit, and continue to be committed. Because being a PA changed my life forever, opened up numerous doors, and really put me on a path to being able to be a servant, and hopefully seen as a servant leader, and willing to be able to give and be part of the solution. This is not just the joy of being able to be in a white coat, short for now, long white coat eventually. Being able to be part of a large hospital system or own your own practice or wherever you want. It's really a commitment to being in a position of service. We are here to be able to make those around us have a better life, a better experience, a better outcome. And that is an amazing process that you will continue to be part of. But it will take grit, it will take perseverance. And we picked you to be here as part of our community because we know you have it, and we know you're committed to it, and you'll continue to be part of the solution. And we're very proud of you for doing that. The practice of medicine is something that very few people are ever able to say they do. The white coat, currently the short white coat, is kind of a membership card. The card is not intended to be an elite card that says you're different or better than others. It's a membership card that really gets you to a position that you are part of a community and you're willing to commit and serve as part of the community. This needs to be done in a selfless manner. Your days will be long, your hours will be stressful, you will be fatigued, and it will be easy for you to become part of the system that really looks at healthcare providers as this elite, looked up to person. That's not how you want to live this profession or your life. Continue to be committed to service, being selfless, and being able to give back. I promise you that someday you'll look back on those decisions and you'll be proud that you did them. I do ask you to stay in acquire mode. When you wanted to get into PA school, you were willing to do a lot. You went through hard classes. You took them over if the first one wasn't exactly perfect. You signed up for hours on nights and weekends to get shadowed and to understand what it would be. You took test after test. You read about how to get into PA school. What's the secret? What's the magic? You're willing to do all of it. And then you get in. And I know all of you will stay and acquire. You need to acquire knowledge. The knowledge is just your foundation. And part of that foundation will build you to be a better and more substantial member of life. So look at this as part of your acquisition of knowledge. Seek out those additional opportunities. When someone says, we could cancel class, I hope you think, don't. When someone says, you can go home from the clinic early, I hope you say, I'd rather not. What is the additional opportunity that I can see? Because that grit and that determination will put you at the top of your class, will put you eventually at the top of your practice, and hopefully doing the great things that I know you all aspire to do. Yes, you continue to use the foundational knowledge Someone told me once that there's a very thin line between confidence and calm, and that line is humility. Humility must be the tether that binds your medical knowledge, your compassionate drive, and your commitment to delivering the highest standard of care. So class of 2025, we are so proud of you for your first semester, and the faculty congratulates you for being here and for all your hard work. So all those who love someone sitting in this room today, please clap and applaud those in their class of 2025.
Symbolized cleanliness, purity, and righteousness, did not fade when washed in high germ-tone temperature, and any soiling was even easily noticed. Since about roughly 1889, which is when aseptic surgery was developed in the United States, the white coat has been a prominent symbol as a physician in the U.S. Photographs from Massachusetts General Hospital during that time frame show surgeons wearing white coats during surgeries in an effort to prevent contamination between physicians and patients they were treating. By the 20th century, healthcare had moved from patients' homes and the hospital. But it was not without its trials. Limited infection control measures, unfamiliar surroundings, and unproven treatments often made the public reluctant to seek the care that was available to them in hospitals. And so to enhance its credibility and reassure the public that hospitals and physicians were indeed safe, medicine began to link itself with science, a field that earns the public's trust and respect. Science had built the Panama Canal, invented the telephone, and made the first human flight possible. By linking science and medicine together, the public's trust began to soften. And by 1920, the white coat had become a powerful and iconic symbol of the physician as a medical science. The white coat ceremony itself, as Dr. Giovanni referenced earlier, is a recent development, originated at Columbia University's College of Physicians in 1993. The ceremony was developed by Dr. Arnold P. Gold, M.D., who sought to bring a humanistic focus to medicine. According to Dr. Gold, a healthcare provider's responsibility is not only to take care of patients, but to care for patients. Think about that for a moment. We can teach you everything, every treatment, standard care, but if we cannot connect with our patients, we have missed the most important treatment that we can do. Don't ever forget that. Today, the white coat ceremony has become a common tradition in many medical and PA schools across the United States, as well as other schools of advanced medical training. The ceremony has even been adopted by many medical schools outside the United States. There are many variations, but perhaps the most common is to hold the white coat ceremony when students begin working with patients, since this usually signals departure from the heavily text and label-dependent early instruction to more practical clinical training. We're going to start just a little bit early. Here at the University of Lynchburg, we hold our short white coat ceremony after the first semester. The students still have two more didactic semesters to go. However, the short white coat heralds the beginning of your first student-patient interaction. All providers wear the short white coat, heralding the fact that they are lifelong learners. In other systems, however, the coat is a very, very accurate indicator of experience. The longer the coat, the higher the status and experience of its wearer. Today, class 2025, you will be coated with the short white coat, which you will wear throughout your training here at the University of Lynchburg. When you return to these hallowed halls to graduate 2 years from now, you will be coated a second time. At that time, you will receive your long white coat, which will symbolize your transition from a student to a professional PA. Thank you.
And I'm one of the cardiologists.
got the hard, the really amazingly, it's not that things won't be difficult in the future in different ways, but you got through it, so it's the finish line is out there. Along the way, it'll be a lot of ups and downs, but you should be confident that you are on the way to it enough. For the rest of us, it brings humility to all of us when we learn how complex healthcare is in general. So I'm going to leave it like that. So I have to bring Dr. Dan Johnson onto the podium to give the keynote address. Dan, probably known almost as long as I've been here in Lynchburg, which is 30 years. He did the fellowship. He did the residency program and found practice in town, and that's probably where I had first contact with him. But most importantly, I've seen him when we take care of patients. And he's kind of what you want to think about as being a consummate physician. Cares about the patient. He also loves, seemingly loves being an educator, so he loves to have students around you guys. It's just the sort of bad part is he is sort of in that, I'm going to use the word transition mode. He's turned the role of medical director to me, albeit in a modified way, back in January. So he's still working, but you won't be able to experience him like many of the people on the stage experienced him when they were in learning mode. And final thought on that before Dan comes up and shares his wisdom with us, we never stop learning. If the acceleration of knowledge and the utility of the speed with which data comes from research labs, clinical trials, to actually making a difference in patients' lives for 6 to 12 months, at least in cardiovascular medicine. So you can't fall behind. But of course, that's the most exciting part about it. It's always changing. What we did 6 months ago is different than what we do now, or at least modified and improving for the best outcome for our patients and their families. So, Dan, your turn. Recently, 2023, U.S. and even in world report. fortunate to have been involved in the development of the program from its inception. For me, it all started back in 2013 after a detailed feasibility study determined that Lynchburg would support the VA program. The first order of business was to hire a medical director, although I served as a member of that feasibility committee. I never once thought about serving as a medical director. Back then, I worked as a full-time ED doc in the second busiest emergency department in the state of Virginia. But as fate would have it, I was asked to consider a new position. At first I said no. I was simply too busy. Didn't feel qualified. But ultimately I agreed to sign on as the program's first medical director. My first order of business was to recruit a qualified program director who would lead the program the rigorous accreditation process. We interviewed quality individuals. But when I met Dr. Jeremy Welsh, I recall being very impressed with him. He just seemed to be a great fit to lead this program. By day two of the interview process, I really believed that he was just what we needed. But I needed to convince him that this was a place for him. So I did something unconventional. I convinced him to skip a few appointments and come with me to Smith Mountain Lake. I really enjoyed the day of sunshine, cold beers. Now, Dr. Welsh may not want to admit it, but I'm convinced that that SML experience is what you got to agree with his team. Since that time, Dr. Welsh and I have had several of them. So we were off to a race car. We recruited outstanding dedicated faculty. Some that are still with us today, including the life of a talented Dr. Bowman, and one of your favorites, Dr. Eric Smith. Over many years, we continue to excel and grow, expanding our class size, placing outstanding students everywhere from rural small town clinics to major medical centers all over this country, representing literally most any specialty you can think of. So here we are today, ranked number 40. While many factors are responsible for catapulting us to that U.S. News and World Report ranking, including our Doctor of Medical Science degree, another one of Dr. Rogers' accomplishments, state-of-the-art building, the counseling of VA program, clinical affiliation agreement with quality medical establishments, including our regional medical center for health. Advanced ultrasound course here at Dr. Bowman, having our very own homegrown talented graduates teaching simulation, physical diagnosis, PBL, and serving as clinical staff. Several of those graduates sit on the stage today. I want them to know that I am so, so very proud of them.
Every single one of you is a testament to the power of ambition, resilience, and perseverance needed to be successful in this program. And hey, if we can conquer Dr. Schmidt's anatomy final, we can conquer anything, right? First, I'd like to take a moment to acknowledge the incredible support system we have behind us. Our families, friends, and loved ones, here and afar, they've cheered us on, celebrated with us, and have probably endured more, sorry, I can't, I have to study, excuses than they signed up for. We have given up time with these important people, family, spouses, friends, to accomplish the beginning of our journey. We are thankful to you. We know you have and continue to sacrifice for us. Let's stand, turn, and give them a round of applause, shall we? Now, I'd like to take a few minutes to reflect on the summer semester. Thanks to Patho, I don't quite look at spaghetti meatballs the same way. Thanks to Swab and a late night study session, I had my first hot pocket since I was about 10 years old. I think our class alone could fund Celsius and Bang Energy drink companies. Unfortunately, those don't come free with tuition. I truly believe that if I woke any single one of you in the middle of the night and asked you to tell me why seagulls are relevant, you could. And I would be remiss if I didn't bring up that spleen from anatomy lab, the fact that a part of our PD grades required us to avert each other's eyelids, and the term thoracodorsal fascia. I know we are all excited to don these crisp white coats, but let's not forget the weight of responsibilities they carry. This ceremony isn't just about the coat you put on. It's about the commitment, the dedication, and the passion it represents. This isn't just any coat. It's a symbol of the countless hours we'll spend poring over textbooks, the countless patients we'll care for, and the countless lives we'll impact. It's a representation of our journey from eager students to passionate healers. As we stand on the threshold of this incredible experience, let us remember that we're stepping into a profession that requires not only medical expertise, but also empathy, compassion, and the ability to make connections with our patients. As we stand here today, let us pledge to wear these coats with pride and honor, knowing that we're committing ourselves to a lifetime of learning and caring for others. Lastly, as we move forward in this program, let's remember that we're not just classmates, we're a family. We're here to support each other through the long nights of studying, the inevitable moments of doubt, and the triumphant successes that lie ahead. Class, today is just the beginning. We're writing the first pages of a story that's going to be filled with challenges, growth, and the kind of impact that will leave a legacy. So let's put on these white coats, embrace the journey ahead, and remind ourselves that the road to becoming outstanding PAs might be long, but it's going to be worth it, and one heck of an adventure along the way. So here's to laughter, here's to tears, and here's to making a difference that resonates far beyond these walls. Congratulations, class of 2025. When I say Frank, we say,